वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, मैं सर डॉक्टर एम एच अन्नय्या, प्रोफेसर ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग एंड वाइस प्रिंसिपल एट सप्तगिरी कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग बैंगलोर। फ्रेंड्स, इन टुडे सेशन आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू हाउ टू ड्रा द आइसोमेट्रिक प्रोजेक्शन ऑफ ए सर्कुलर लैमिना, दैट ऑफ ए कोन एंड ऑल्सो ए सिलेंडर। Friends, you know very well, in the previous sessions I have told you, the circular lamina or cylinder or a cone, they have curved periphery and they do not have any edges. So when any of these circular lamina or thin circular plates are just viewed at an angle, they appear as ellipse. So let me start the session today with the isometric projection of a circular lamina. So here I am going to take the example of a circular plate, a very thin circular plate, and tell you how to draw the isometric projections. So there are two methods generally used to draw the isometric projection of a circular lamina. So one of them is by four-point method, or by the method of points we can call it, and second is by the four-center method. So I am going to tell you both the methods. And let us take the example of a circular lamina of diameter say 100 mm and tell you how to draw the isometric projection by both the methods. Now I have the circular lamina say of diameter 50 mm. I want to draw the isometric projection of this. So what that we do? We write the top view of that. That is a circle of the diameter given. And here I am going to split this or divide this equally into 8 equal parts. So this is having a diameter 50 mm. I will write it as 550, 5 indicating that the diameter is 50 mm, and this I have divided into 8 equal parts, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 parts. Now let us say, since it has got a curved periphery, I am going to enclose this figure in a box. So since it is a circle, if you enclose it in a box, that box is going to be a perfect square. So this is how I have enclosed the figure in a box by name PQRS. P, this is Q, this is R, and this is S. Now friends, my aim is to draw the isometric projection of this circular lamina. That is, isometric projection is drawing the isometric view of that using isometric scale. So let me start from this end. When you are viewing this lamina from this end, P is there. So I just write down a reference line here and mark that point P anywhere on that. So to the right of P is Q. Write a line at an angle of 30 degrees, and mark a length PQ equal to 50 mm. So this 50 mm is nothing but 50 mm ISO. So what are the dimensions you are writing here? 50 ISO. That means it is going to be approximately 50 into 0.815, around 42 millimeter. Similarly, write another line to the left, also of same length, and you get the point S here. I will just mark this point as S. So this is PQ. I should get the point R. So from here, I am going to write a line parallel to that. Another line from here, parallel to this edge. So this line is parallel to this. This line is parallel to this. This point we call it as R. So we have got four corners of the plate PQRS, and this figure is drawn to a scale called isometric scale, in which the actual dimensions are already, you know, written to 0.815 times. That is, this is 50 into 0.815. This is 50 into 0.815. All are 50 into 0.815. Friends, I told you there are two methods to draw the ellipse. The isometric projection of the circle is an ellipse. So the most preferably used method is by the method of four centers method. That is, how to draw the ellipse in this box PQRS using four center method. So please follow it clearly. It is very simple, and once you know the isometric projection of a lamina, it is very easy to construct the isometric projection of a cone or frustum of a cone or a cylinder, etc. The procedure is very simple, my dear friends. You write a horizontal line through these, through SQ, and a vertical line from there. This is a vertical line, this is a horizontal line. That is, I have joined the opposite side diagonals of this rhombus. Here, as the method indicates, it is a four center method used to draw the ellipse. That means there will be four different centers which you are going to take as a center and draw the ellipse. So what do you do that? See friends, here you got this point P. Join this point P to the center of the opposite side. So P is here, the opposite side is SR, mark the center of that, center of these two. Join that here by a thin line. So you have got a point here. I call this point as C1. So how to get C1? Join P to the center of the opposite side SR, midpoint of this. It meets this horizontal diagonal C1. So C1 is one center. So with center C1 and radius equal to this gap from here to here, you draw an arc. So what that we have done? Taken center C1 and radius equal to this distance, we have drawn an arc. Likewise, you can join P to the center of the opposite side, this side. Suppose say you have got this center here, you draw a giant thin line, you are going to get this center C2, follow the same procedure. What that we do? With center C2 and same radius, you draw another arc here. Friends, you have got one arc with center C1, second arc with center C2, P itself becomes center C3, another center from which we are going to draw the arc. So with center P and radius equal to P to this gap, or P to this gap, you draw another arc. So friends, you have got three centers, C1, C2, C3. Similarly, this point R is center number 4, fourth center. With center R and radius equal to this gap, R from here to here, complete this ellipse. Friends, this is the isometric projection of a circular lamina. It is nothing but an ellipse. It becomes an ellipse. And this is used using four center method, center C1, C2, C3 and C4. This is the most convenient way of drawing the ellipse. That is by four center method, and it also saves lot of time when you are drawing the isometric projections of the frustum of cone or that of a cylinder or a cylindrical block, etc. I hope friends are able to follow this. So after completing the isometric projection of the circular lamina, let us take the example of the isometric projection of a cone. Friends, you know, the cone has a circular base that is joined to the apex of the cone, the top point. So it is joined to the apex or vortex by number of generators. So here what we do, we have the center of this box. I will call this as the center. And now I want to draw the isometric projection of the cone. Suppose say the height of the cone is given to be 70 mm or 60 mm. See, this is 60 mm height, the diameter of the base is say same 50. So how to draw that? You know that you have the center O1, that is the center of the bottom face. Draw a vertical line from there. You draw a vertical line, and after getting this vertical line, say this is your O dash, which is at an isometric height, O dash O1 dash equal to 60 times 0.815, approximately 50 mm. So obtain that apex. O dash is the apex of the cone. So after getting that, it is very simple. You have to just draw tangent to this curve from this O dash. From O dash, draw a line tangential to this curve. Maybe you will get something like this. You will get a tangent. Similarly, on the other end also, draw a tangent to that. So you have the tangents drawn from the apex to this ellipse. Friends, once you have joined this, you know this cone is an opaque body. You will not be able to see this portion of the solid which comes inside the object. So generally after completing this, we are going to show this part of the curve or this part of the ellipse by a very thin line, or even you can omit this line. You can omit this line or show by a very thin line. And this figure with these generators darkened and this generator will give you the complete isometric projection of a cone having diameter equal to 50 mm and height equal to 60 millimeters. So I will just show here this height as 60 ISO, means isometric height. So this is the construction of the isometric projection of a cone. Friends, I hope you are able to follow the projection, the isometric projection of this cone. And after this, the last part for today's session is the construction of the isometric projection of a cylinder. Friends, you know very well, the cylinder has got both at the top and the bottom these circular ends. So what we do in this procedure is that we construct the circular base, draw vertical lines from all these four corners, construct another box PQRS at the top, construct an ellipse there, draw tangents to both the ellipse to get the isometric projection of the cylinder. So I will just do it separately. So we are left with the isometric projection of a cylinder. I write down here, I want isometric projection of a cylinder having diameter 50 mm and axis or height equal to 70 mm, say 70 mm. Friends, the procedure is very simple. The base is an ellipse, the top face is also an ellipse, and this connected by two vertical generators of the cylinder. So let me take this figure itself as the top view of the cylinder. So I am going to construct a box here on a reference line with P, point P here, a line here at an angle PQ equal to 50 ISO, means 50 into 0.815, this angle is 30 degree, you know very well. Similarly, another line here at the same angle or the same dimension, this is your S. So PQ is equal to PS is equal to 50 times ISO, 50 into 0.812. From here, you write a vertical line and here a line parallel to that, a line parallel somewhere from here. So this is the box I have constructed, PQRS. Remember friends, in all these squares, the vertical drawn through this point P should pass through R compulsorily. In other words, this PR is always perpendicular to this reference line drawn through the point. Friends, you have the base here drawn to isometric scale. Similarly, the better method is to have another such figure at the given height. So I locate the center of this. From here I take a height, or from all these corners, corner P, Q, R, S, etc., you draw vertical lines of height equal to 70 into 0.81. So I have drawn from here, join all these corners. That is, I have taken from every point corner. That is, yes, height is equal to 70 iso, from here 70 iso, 70 iso, from here 70 iso. Join all those points by thin lines to start with. So I will draw one line here, another line, a line from here, a line from here. Friends, remember, we got one more line here also. Friends, remember here, the box what I have considered here and this box, they are the same. We can call this as S1, P1, Q1, R1. Remember, these two boxes are identical. And this is the center of the top face. We will call it as O dash. Here this is O1 dash. While teaching you the isometric projection of these prisms, I had told you the top face of that object, whether it is a prism or a pyramid or a cone, is completely visible to the observer. So here, friends, by using four center method, I am going to draw an ellipse in this rhombus. You know the method, friends? I will repeat again. Join P1 to the center of the opposite side, so you get a point here. This is your center C1. Center C1 and radius equal to this much, you draw an arc. Similarly, if you join this P1 to the center of the opposite side here, it is cutting somewhere here. That is your center C2. With center C2, same radius, you draw the second arc. Likewise, friends, center C3 is our P1. So with center P1 and radius equal to this curve, see please, from here to here, or from here to here, just draw another R. So finally, with center R1, that is center number C4, and radius, same radius, you complete this. So you have this ellipse inside this box, P1, Q1, R1, S1. Friends, for the bottom face also, you have a similar figure. So you follow the same procedure and get here, that is, if C1 is here, simply you can project it downward here. So it will meet somewhere here. So take this as the center, say for the bottom face, same radius, you draw an arc. Likewise here also, you are going to join this P to the opposite side center. It will meet somewhere here. Then this is your center. Draw the arc. So front face is always visible, I told you. Complete that. And dear friends, after obtaining these two ellipses you get here are exactly identical. This will be just identical. Now you draw two tangents from this vertical face. So I am going to draw a tangent to this. One tangent here. Second tangent to this. So friends, here this will give you the isometric projection of a cylinder having diameter 50 mm and height, this height whatever you marked here, is this height. This is given as 70, that is 70 isometric. The figure what I have shown in dark lines is the isometric projection, and here to make this figure more beautiful, you can just omit this part of the curve which is hidden. So this figure will give you the isometric projection of a right circular cylinder. Friends, I hope you all have followed this part of the isometric projection of the cylinder. Friends, I thank you all very much for the interest you have been showing. And I wish you all best of luck. Have a wonderful day. And this is Dr. M.H. Annaya signing off.